So we are coming to the very interesting part of the limes, and it is the left limes or right limes. What that means, this is left limes. When we in the different limits. But interesting later to know if both of them is equal, what that means. Okay? So we are going to value of x2 minus 2x. When x goes to 2, you see that this is absolute value. Then then we are going to make a tab table to find the sign. This is for x0 and for x2, this is 0. If x is 0, how I find 0 and 2? It is x multiplied by x minus 2 equals to 0. Then x is 0 or x is 2 or both. So for x less than 0, then less than 0, this expression is negative, and if expression is negative, negative multiple negative is positive. If between 0 and 2, this one is positive, but this one is negative, then the solution, the multiple is negative. If bigger than 2, this is positive, this is positive, then it is positive. Then, now we can say that that is limit x to minus 2x when x goes to goes to 2 plus, means that from right goes, and the sign is plus. Then it is 0, because it's going to be 2 Aynen. Two multiplied by two is four minus four is zero. And limit from left is going to be minus x two minus two x when x goes to two from left side, then it is minus two quarter by two minus two whole multiplied by minus two. This is four and this is four, then it is minus eight. Example. Another example is the x two minus square x minus one over by two. Is x2 minus absolute value of x minus 1 divided by x minus 1. Then we see that it is 1, and from left side this expression is positive, from left side this expression is negative. Then we are going to tell when x goes to 1 from right side, then we have x2 minus x1, and this is 1, this is x2 minus 1, and this is 1 followed by 2 minus 1, this is 0. And when x from left goes to 1, then x2 minus x minus 1 divided by x minus 1. And this is x2 minus 1. This is x followed by 2. Plus 1, and it goes to 1, it's 1 followed by 2, plus 1, it is 2. Now we are going to have another. It is square 2x minus 4. When x goes to 2 from right side, when x bigger than 2, then this part is bigger than 4. Then this part is positive. But we must twice for each value, positive value, little positive value, theta, there exists a figure, a very little positive value alpha, so that x minus 2 is varied from 2, not from 0, from 2 less than from 0 and alpha and beta and square 2 is minus 4. But if we replace 2 here, 2 minus 2 is 4 minus 4 is 0. So this expression, x minus 2 is always positive because it is between those two, then it is x minus 2 is between those, but we can add 2 in each spot, then it is 2x plus 2, and this part up plus 2x minus 4 less than beta, because this expression is going to be positive 2, and we put away the absolute value, and 2x minus 4 is bigger than beta process, and it is plus 4, and then divided by 2, it is 6, then alpha is bigger than n or equal to beta 2 plus 4 divided by 2. Now we are going to have another then x goes from right side to 5 and the value is plus infinity. For this you must also find for each very big positive value n, there exists a very little positive value alpha, then minus 5 up to is bounded between 0 and alpha, then 1 divided by x minus 5 is bigger than n. Yes, because x goes from right side to 5, then x bigger than 5, then that expression is positive. Then become x between 5 and alpha plus 5. Now we can watch x minus 5 less than 1 divided by n. Means in x x divided by x minus 2 and this 2 from that part, and then this here minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 and this here. So you have here x because x goes to 2 from right side, then this part is positive, then x minus 2 less than alpha. Now here that x minus 2 divided by x is less than n, then this x must be minimum, and x goes to 2 from right side, and x is minimum, then x is 2, then x minus 2 divided by 2 less than n, then x minus 2 less than 2n, then alpha is less than or equal to 2n. That's how you can see. Okay, we are coming to another expression. Function is continuous. Then when x goes to n from right side, I can see limit f of x goes to n from right side equals to limit f of x when x goes from left side equals to f of a. Then you have a continuous function like this one. From left side, from right side, and that one. And in this value, so then the function is continuous. You take example f of x equals to x plus 1, then x greater than 1 is x minus 1, then x less than 1, and if it's 0, then x equals to 1. again. Nine. F of x. X goes from right side to 1. Means that x is greater than 1. Then we have limit x plus 1, x goes to this one, and this is x, n to x, 2. Now limit f of x, x goes to 1 from left side. It is this. Then it is limit x minus 1, x goes to 1 from left side. Then it is 1 minus 1 is 0. And for x is equal to 1, f of x is 0. Then we have a continuous from left side. And the function is look like so. Then x less than 1 is here. Then you see that point doesn't fit in that point. Then it is 3. Then function f has a left side continuous, not right side continuous. Another example is we are going to write correct. It is x2 minus absolute x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 and 2. Which means that minus 2, then x is goes to 1 minus, and x 2 minus, or we can say that x reflect on it. If it is minus 2, it's minus 2. When it is greater than 1, plus 1, the other one is equal to x2 minus 1 and 2, then x greater than 1, x less than 1, and x equal to 1. You see that here is x minus minus 1 is x plus 1. Now, f of x equals to 1 plus 1 is 2. F of x is 1 minus 1 is 0. And f of 1 is 2. Then f is continuous from right of 1. Another example is f of x equals to, well, this is 2 plus y plus m squared x minus 2 divided by x minus 2, and this is power and x minus 2. And m of 2 equals to 4. Squared is 2 plus 5 plus absolute is minus 2 is minus 2 and f of 2 is 4. And this is x2 plus 5 minus 1, then x less than 2, and square x plus 5 plus 1, then x greater than 2, and both is equal to 2. What happens? When x is less than 2, then this one is negative. Then it is this one negative divided by this, it is minus 1. Bigger than 2, this is positive. This is this divided by this, is 1. And when x is 2, the value of this function is 4. Now we put 2 in that, it is 2 power by 2 plus y plus 1. equals to 4 plus 5, which is 9, plus 1, which is 3 plus 1 is 4. The another is 2, followed by 2 plus 5, which is 9, minus 1. The first was minus 1. The second is. Three plus one is four, and it equals to two is four. Then F is continued from function can be opposite F inverse is the F. And we saw these, we are telling why he goes to minus 4. Then x equals to y plus 4 divided by 2, which is x inverse. And equals to x3 plus 1 divided by x equals to 1. Thank you. divided by 2, 1 and 2, equals to minus b times 1 for 2 plus minus 2 divided by 2 minus 8b 2 plus 1. It is 4 minus 2, it is 2 plus 1. Then, this one divided by 2 is 2 plus 2, 2 plus 1. And x2 divided by 2 is 2 minus 2 plus 1. Then the solution of this is x bar plus minus and plus of this plus minus. So we have four different equations. Okay? And we are going to start the derivative of the function. I am going to check in this maybe if I have left something there. I have left something, I don't think so. We are going to start the derivative in another in the following video. Have a nice day.